All right, let's pick up on that with by looking at some of the other cartoons that we Vadot selected with us. When we spoke to you hours after the shooting, Vadot, on Wednesday, you told us of your lack of inspiration. We'll show one that that you put up in it. There's a cartoonist who's sitting at his desk drawing, and he's saying, "Stay focused. Act as normal as possible. Laugh out loud. Most important, laugh out loud." And he's sweating. Is that you in that cartoon?
Well, I do it. I did it at just an hour before the deadline, so I had to be quick on that, and I left it as a sketch because I didn't want to finish it, because for me the story wasn't ended and wasn't ending, and I wanted to keep it as a rough cartoon basically. And but that's what we do for a living. The best way to fight these people is to keep on drawing, and even if a tragedy happens, we will deliver a cartoon the next day.
And let's pick up on that, because there's
for the past 25 years.
Let's pick up on that, because what we're seeing in a lot of the cartoons you've selected is defiance. First, let's show one from Gado in Kenya, and there you see a pencil that is. Let's see if we'll call up that cartoon. There it is. Not a rude gesture with the hashtag Je suis Charlie.
He's giving us the finger.
He's giving the finger. Bertrams, the Dutch cartoonist, has a beheaded colleague sticking his tongue out at the jihadist. Perhaps we can show that one. There it is. The jihadist, a little startled by all of that. And I guess in a premonition of things to come, I really like this one. Dubus sharpening his pencil. And saying, "Let's get to work, au boulot," as they say in French. That says you've been saying, Nicolas Vadot, that's what you're going to be doing.
Yeah. And Dubus is he works in Belgium, and I saw this in the papers this morning. He's not part of Cartooning for Peace, but I selected it anyway, because that's exactly what I thought and what other fellow cartoonist thought. And the thing is, he's sharpening his pencil, which happens to be his own knife, and the knife he's holding looks like the knives the beheaders in Syria use when they do their dirty job. And this cartoon goes to show that these terrorists shot themselves in the foot, because they encouraged us to keep on working and keep on challenging and tackling what they hate, which is freedom of speech and freedom in its own right.
Nicolas Vadot, we were talking just a moment ago about how, you know, derision, making a blasphemy, these are French sports, and even Bernard Guetin and Anisbeth Moutet were saying, even when you don't agree, people get it. A lot of the time. There are lawsuits, though, and Charlie Hebdo has been the subject of many of them. But if, as Michael Kirtley says, the rest of the world doesn't have the same understanding of that humor, are we headed to a world where you won't be able to draw where you want, what you want to draw?
Well, I hope not. But the thing I'd like to emphasize on that particular matter is that blasphemy, like freedom of speech, is part of the French spirit, but it's part of the Republican pact, if I may say so. And this seems to have to they try to break it on that week, and that's very saddening. And the response of the French population was something great for us cartoonists, I think, from everyone around the world, because they supported this tradition of not only blasphemy but freedom of speech altogether. And I think political cartoonists will be, even at a high cost, will be stronger than before after the events.